My name is Bilal Bhatt. I am a journalist and human rights activist from Srinagar, Kashmir. I was traveling from from Delhi to Kuala Lumpur on 13th, and I was stopped and denied access by the immigration. Unfortunately, they didn't allow me without citing any strong reason why they stopped me. I was flying to Kuala Lumpur because I was invited by Children and Youth Assembly. It was basically organized by United Nations in association with the government of Malaysia. And I was selected as a delegate, and so that means that I was representing India as my country. While I was attending this conference in Malaysia, subsequently I wanted to visit the university because I wanted to get admission in the university. I wanted to pursue my studies further, but unfortunately they didn't let me they didn't let me go. And I showed them my phone, I showed them the name of the university, an email. I was about to tell them, see my phone, I'm not going to do anything politics. Had I told them the very first time that I'm a journalist, they would have, I'm 100% sure, they would have rejected at the very first moment. I would have not got this kind of stamp, the immigration stamp. I'm 100% sure when they would have come to know that I'm a journalist. I think after probing more and more, when they were taking time inside the office, they were discussing something. I thought something is cooking, and yes, they were basically probing about my background. Then they came to know he's a journalist, and it's that point of time they must have decided that they should cancel it, and they canceled it. When I was at the immigration, they told me, why are you going? I said, I am a tourist. They told me, what do you do? I said, I am a businessman. I didn't tell them, actually, I was a journalist and I was going for conference. Why I was hiding things is because they had already offloaded two of my friends. Gawar Gilani, he is a journalist. He was offloaded. I thought they will offload me. And my apprehensions came true when they offloaded me, despite telling them that I'm a tourist. On the tourist thing, they offloaded me. When I would have been telling them that I am going for a conference, then they will think that he is going to Malaysia, now he is going to talk about in a UN conference, that too in a United Nations conference. They would be having this kind of notion that I will be speaking on Kashmir human rights thing, which was not in my mind. Honestly, I was not going to do that. So at that point of time, I didn't want to have any debate, political debate with them, but purely that I told them that I am doing business, which is true. I am doing business. I have my side business also, and I told them that I am going to visit university, which I was ought to visit that university. I had the emails, I had the WhatsApp message with the university. I was not able to produce documents, so I wanted to have word with the university. So I was having the chance to explore Malaysia, take part in the conference, and also visit the university. So but my whole hopes were dashed when I was offloaded. I was representing my country, and this was a proud moment for me, and I felt very bad, very shaken, that they didn't allow me because I am a Kashmiri. And I shouted, like in anger, I shouted, I was frustrated. Why? When my other fellow Indians, they enjoy this, they enjoy the rights that the government of India has guaranteed, but why not me? I felt like, you know, I was like an criminal standing there in the, I felt like, you know what they call us, terrorists, Kashmiris are terrorists. I felt like that. See, Because I am an activist, I am a human rights activist. Once I had conducted a program, I was not detained like that. They had stopped me from doing that program. That was it. It is not like I was officially detained or like that. In a way, the criminals are. I had not done any kind of criminal activity. See, you get passport in Kashmir only when your record is clean. Clean from the militant background, clean from any criminal background. So I was not having anything, because getting a passport in Kashmir is not that easy. I had a lot of things in mind, you know. I have read being a journalist, being into education thing. So we read a lot of about our constitution, our rights. So as of now, I was thinking that I should approach the BJP government, BJPCL, Home Ministry. At one point of time, I think I should reach out to them. Even I should approach court, Supreme Court. So at one point of time, I hope. But at another point of time, my hopes are dashed. Because the way the Kashmiris are being treated these 3 months, I think they will not listen to me.